Beautiful place. My name is Mike Mills from the UK, the land of warm beer and irony and stale food. Thanks. I'm going to play some acoustic guitar for you this evening. I'm going to kick things off with the first tune that I wrote back in 2007 when I was 17 years old. This is an old tune called Boogie Shred. Here we go. In England, yes. They're quiet and subdued. Any Van Halen fans in the house tonight? Alright. This one's for Eddie. Here we go. Thank you. This song is dedicated to our 2020 social lives. It's called Somebody That I Used to Know. So I did a lot of writing on the guitar, back where I live in a town called Bristol in England. Has anyone been to Bristol? Famous for Banksy and Blackbeard the Pirate. I had a lot of free time there and I did a bit of writing. That Eddie Van Halen tribute was one of the things that I did as a tribute to really the greatest of all time, my hero Eddie Van Halen. Round of applause for Eddie Van Halen! But I wanted to do something else in tribute of another guitar player here, really the greatest kind of acoustic guitar player on my radar, really. A man who passed away a few decades ago, but was really influential in the style of guitar that I play. Has anyone heard of Michael Hedges? Fantastic. So Michael was an amazing player from Enid, Oklahoma. And one of the things that he did was a lot of guitar covers and things like that. And he did a really cool singer-songwriter version of the song that I'm about to play now. But he sang it, and I don't sing. My singing is for the shower, the car, and my gran at Christmas, right? So I was really inspired by this version, so I wanted to attempt my version of a Michael Hedges version of a Jimi Hendrix version of a Bob Dylan song. So this isn't exactly finished. I started this about a week before I left for this tour. But it's really almost really raw. I think in a big old room like the Paramount here, I think it'll sound pretty cool. Is that okay if I play it for you? Fantastic. So you can guess what it is. It's pretty abstract. It's like that child's game Whispers, where you start with the initial idea and it becomes progressively more abstract and distorted. But maybe some of you will pick up on it. So this is my new little ditty here. Let's go.
I'm instrument and an actual live gig through an actual PA system. So for those of you that didn't guess already, it's a little... Bring it down now. I'm going to build up the end of this track. At the end of this one, I'm going to use it as an opportunity to get rid of all the negative bullshit of the last 18 months and replace it with good vibes, yeah? Stuff. I do have a bunch of things out front with a lady called Sophia just around the corner there. I have both of my studio albums that I've been playing music from. One has cartoons on it, one doesn't. As well as a brand new album that I released last year that I just brought out for this tour. It's a live album that I recorded in New York in November 2019. Yeah, it's called Shows and Distancing, Live in the USA. And it's dedicated to all of you, the USA audiences that have been so kind to me over the recent years. It was recorded entirely in New York, Florida, and LA, actually. And yeah, we did a gig over in Central Park a couple of years ago. Was anyone there? You know the area, the last Justin Hayward show in New York. You guys were there. I'm really proud of the record, so I have a bunch of other signed copies out there, as well as some other little trinkets. And one other thing that I must just mention while I'm tuning in. For anyone interested in learning this style of guitar playing, I flew over to Colorado with this American company called Jam Play and recorded this 9-hour mega guitar tuition video thing, multiple camera angles explaining how it all works, from the basics all the way to the crazy stuff. And we put it in this little gift box on this cute little guitar-shaped USB stick that you can keep in. And it looks so cool and very James Bondy, you know. I have about 10 of them left for this tour that are all out there. And I wanted to come up with a name that sounded so mighty as I believed the content I had created was. So I decided to call it The Master Course. Yeah, it's pretty epic. So guys, it's been once again a real pleasure to play for you. I'm going to end with the lead single from the live album. This is my cover of a John Mayer tune called Slow Dancing in a Burning Room. You guys have been amazing. Thank you so much for welcoming me to the band. But these are my biggest fans.
Let's end this one now with a nice little sing-along.
Actually, no, we'll make it a hummer lock. Closed mouths, very sanitary. Why don't I get you guys along here? Just joining me in humming along with these two notes. Very simple. Let's see if you can do it. Like this, and simply click along with it. So we have our choir on the bottom, and our little percussion section on top. This sounds beautiful. Keep it going to the end, okay? Thank you so much, guys. See you very soon. Cheers.